Okay, what's good?
I can't believe he ate it. There's something down there. Come here. What can you tell me about that giant lady with the bow?
She was called Skadi, Queen of the Hunt. Her father was Thjotsi, who could take the shape of any wild creature, and taught Skadi how to hunt them all. From the ribs of pack beasts, she fashioned second feet, allowing her to glide upon the snow so no animal could evade her. She became a huntress beyond compare, even to any god. Odin himself wanted her for his bride, believing she would bear him strong sons. But she spurned his affections. And for that insult, Odin vowed revenge. It was put forth that the Aesir were plagued by an eagle who would steal the precious golden apples of Idun. Not even the finest archer among the gods could bring it down. Odin knew that Skadi could not resist the temptation to prove herself superior, and so she joined the hunt. Skadi tracked the eagle as it flew where she alone could glide, and loosed an arrow from her unerring bow. When she collected her quarry, she found no eagle at all, but her own father, poor Thjotsi, slain by his own daughter. She was overcome with grief and shame, for there is nothing nature so reviles as a child who kills their parent. Skadi succumbed to her fate as winter's blanket fell, holding her father as the mountain held her, in an embrace to last eternity.
Well, that was sad.
Aye. There aren't many happy endings for the giants, I'm afraid.
Their name. Rota!
It's as if they've been made into a memorial to the Valkyries.
betray us to me.
Can we try to free her?
We can't just leave her like this, brother.
Do not rush me, Ed. When we are prepared, I will attack.
Thank you.
freedom.
Where is your queen?
My queen?
She did this to you. She's letting the dead take over Midgard.
This cannot be.
I didn't want to believe it either, m'lady. But we have to find her.
Where is she?
I can't say for sure, but... the Rokstol of Valkyrs. If the Council of Eight are reunited, perhaps she will answer our call.
Looks like this was our last one.
Aye, lad. On to the Rokstol of Valkyrs, then. If you remember, it's next to the two oarsmen statues on the path we took to Thamur's Chisel.
This queen of yours, she is strong, yes? Stronger than these other Valkyries we have faced.
That's putting it mildly, brother.
Then we must prepare ourselves.
Ludwig's bones scattered around these beaches.
She was too pure, too beautiful, too charming. She inspired great jealousy amongst others, and they desecrated her poor body.
This is it, right? The Rockstall?
Aye, lad. The Council of Valkyries.
The Valkyries are of Valhalla, are they not?
Glad to see you're paying attention, brother. You are correct. Valhalla, the great hall of the Einherjar, home within Asgard. But while there, they are subject to the scrutiny of the Allfather himself. And relations between the Valkyries and Odin were tense during my tenure as his advisor.
Wow.
Well, that's an even longer story, lad. For now, why don't we look around for some clues? Try placing one of the Valkyrie helms on a throne. Thinks he can hear you, lad. The helms must only retain but a small portion of their owner. I'd wager the rest is in transit to Valhalla to try and fix the mess left by their absence.
Here. Who is she?
Gunnar, Mistress of War. After any conflict, big or small, she would be first on the scene, sussing out the worthy spirits for a free trip to Valhalla. A gruesome task, but she took great pride in it.
Any conflict? Impossible.
It's true. She had help from her sisters, of course, but Gunnar was always first to arrive. Her judgment of the fallen was unparalleled, and an invaluable resource to Odin. She was one of his favorites.
Story or anything?
Sorry, lad. The sight of Gondul always took my breath away. Gondul had a silver tongue, a sharp wit, and struck a figure so stunning it literally drove men insane. Odin forbid her from setting foot in Midgard after a time, as insanity is not a welcome trait in Valhalla. This is none other than Geirdrifol, the master of arms in Valhalla, responsible for arming and training Odin's Einherjar.
His what?
His army, come Ragnarok. The entire reason Valhalla exists, you see. The Einherjar wait in the Great Hall endlessly, feasting, drinking, and fornicating themselves silly. Once Ragnarok begins, Odin calls them into service to fight on his behalf. Geirdrifol had her hands full training that lot. This, my friends, is Kara. Now, Valkyries are volatile by nature, but Kara, the lass is Wild Storm personified.
A Wild Storm?
Aye, calm and collected. Then the air would shift and the fury of her storm would unleash. It was beautiful in a way, assuming you could find proper shelter. Her tears would cleanse the blood-soaked battlefields. This is Rota, a chooser of the slain.
I thought all the Valkyrie did that.
Not exactly, lad. Although that is what they're most famous for, and by far their greatest responsibility. You've seen what happens to the dead without the judgment of the Valkyries.
Hellwalkers.
That's right. Rota, Gunnar, Skuld. Without them to clean up the aftermath of battle, Hell overflows with souls meant for Valhalla. A sorry state of affairs. Rota must be beside herself. We have Eir, the healer.
A Valkyrie healer? Strange.
Eir was strange, as a matter of fact. Very quiet, very calm. Where her sisters were violent rapids, Eir was a gentle stream. She healed the wounds of both mortals and gods, and even a certain all-knowing sage who once drank too much and fell off a mountain. Not my proudest moment. Well, Hildr, Mistress of Battle. She and Odin got on quite well, actually. Her and the other Valkyries, not so much. She would spend most of her time here in Midgard observing discord between the living, and sewing some up herself from time to time. She lived for conflict. Some say she was conflict personified. I wonder what will become of her now that she's free. Once the daughter of a powerful chieftain, she fell defending him during a Reaver attack. Olrun was escorted to Valhalla, where she chose to devote her afterlife to the pursuit of knowledge above all else. Quite unusual behavior amongst the constant drinking and feasting of her fellow Valhallian denizens.
How'd she end up a Valkyrie?
Odin. He saw a kindred spirit in Olrun's single-minded pursuit of knowledge. He appointed her as the Valkyrie's resident historian.